Hello everyone. This is a follow-up video on importing icons. There was a known limitation with the previous version. The image import tool was only able to import outlines. For instance, take a look at the arrow icons in this PDF. The original icons are solid, but the imported icons, using the settings we discussed in the previous video, end up as outline icons. You might be wondering why PySN handles image imports this way, essentially simplifying the images. The short answer is to keep your notebook size reasonable. Now for a bit more detail. As of today, the Supernote Notebook file doesn't store image objects. Sure, you can bring in images through templates, but those images can't be erased or resized, and so on. The folks at Supernote are working on a new tool and format to handle image and text imports, and I imagine they'll embed those as separate objects. But until then, if we want to bring text or images into a Supernote notebook using PySN, we gotta rely on pen stroke objects. If you've seen the earlier videos, you know that in the Supernote system, a pen stroke is basically a vector path complete with pen type, color, and weight, plus an envelope of points. A vector point is an ordered list of coordinates that connect to form a path, like tracking the pen while it's pressed down and moving on the screen. All those details get rendered by the tablet whenever you open the file. And as you might guess, that can add up to a lot of data, especially when representing images this way. That's why detecting and storing just the outline of an image is a good way to shrink that data size while still keeping the essence of the image. Make sense? We'll see in a future video how PySN uses a pencil sketch technique to simplify more complex images. Okay. But what if you want your icons to have a particular fill color? One way is to generate filling pen strokes in the areas where the tool detects closed shapes. Bear in mind, though, if you choose a fill color that's the same as the outline color, you risk losing some detail, especially if the image has multiple shapes. We'll go over how PySN tackles that. A basic fill method is available in PySN version 1.34 or later. It might still need a bit of optimization, but it works well enough right now. All right, enough of the geek talk. Let's see this in action. If you haven't caught the previous episodes, just remember that image imports need specific settings stored in the same folder as your source file. Let's jump in with some demo files. By the way, we introduced a demo global parameter. Files in the listed folders will be processed by PySN even if they haven't changed, which is handy for rerunning PySN while you tweak parameters. Okay, back to our background color parameters. Detect shapes is required if you want PySN to fill shapes. We can't fill what we haven't identified, right? Next, choose your filling color. Since the Supernote's background is generally white, we have three practical choices: light gray, dark gray, or black. Lastly, shapes show border is a parameter that helps when the outline color matches the fill color. Right now, the outline color is hard-coded as black, so if your fill color is also black, you might lose detail if you don't tweak this. We've got two PDF sources for today's demo, a set of arrows and some tech icons. First, let's run it with shape score detect set to false, which is the default. And you can see here the new demo feature message. That gives us the usual outline images. Let's rename these files with no detect for comparison purposes. Next, we'll turn on shapes detection and pick a light gray fill. Most of the shapes get filled in, though you might see some missing patches. You can zoom in and edit those directly. That's for the arrows. Now for the tech icons. Here's what we get. Now, comparing to the previous file size, we can see that filling more than doubled the size of the files. All right? Okay, what if you wanted a black filling color, like in the original arrow PDF? Let's just do that. The arrows are now filled with black, but the border looks a bit ugly. For the tech icons, it's, well, okay-ish. Remember the shape show border parameter? That parameter is by default true to let PySN pick a color whenever the outline color black is the same as the filling color. PySN picked dark gray. So let's change that parameter to false and run one more time. The arrows look how we want, but the tech icons are mostly unusable, so it might make sense to separate your imports into something like plain black and light folders. We're almost done, folks. One last note, if you want to use these filled icons as headings, check out this example. The best style is the fourth one, the hash style. All the others lose detail, even though they look the same. In the table of contents. Here is an overview of the tech icons with and without filling. All right, that's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos. In the meantime, happy writing.